The Harry Potter dolls give us fully articulated kid-sized dolls, standing about 10 inches tall. So we are going to turn Ginny Weasley into 11 from Stranger Things. I originally wanted to use Hermione because she has the brown hair and the brown eyes, but she's just a little too smiley. So Ginny it is. Let's start with a trip to the hair salon. Is anybody here? Welcome to the Curl Up and Dye Salon. Have a seat. I want a new look. Surprise me. Wow, I have creative freedom. I never thought this day would come. But you know, stranger things have happened. First, we have to remove the factory hair. I remove the head to take the hair from the inside, take brown yarn, cut a piece of yarn, unravel it to thin it out, push a loop of fishing line through the eye of a needle, put the yarn through the fishing line, then pull it to thread the needle with the yarn. Push the needle through one of the holes in the doll's head, coming out through the neck. I like to use pliers for a little extra help. Carefully remove the needle, tie a knot in the yarn, then pull the other end until the knot is against the head. Trim off the excess, then pull the yarn on the other side, and it should be secured in place. Repeat until the whole head is done. Now it's time for a little haircut. I got this! I am going to cut this as low as I can and hopefully not show too much scalp. I'm just cutting a little bit of hair at a time because it's easier to take away than it is to put back on. Now that it's cut short, I can see a few spots. So I threaded my needle with yarn. I didn't untwist it this time, and I am going to fill in some of those spaces. I have pretty good coverage now, and I've cut it as low as I can. She just looks a little too happy. I use nail polish remover to remove her lipstick and eyebrows. I use acrylic paint to make her eyes brown and looking up, and I am painting right over the existing eye. I repaint the eyebrows a little lower. I add a tiny touch of pink, just a little dry brushing. I added a little brown to bring out some detail in her lips and in her nose, then added a little more pink to her lips and a glaze. Carefully cover the doll's head with painter's tape, add hot glue around the cap of the doll's head, making a glue helmet. And remember to always have adult supervision when crafting. Allow it to cool, then carefully remove it from the doll. Remove the tape to have a mold of the doll's head. Cut pieces of yarn, add glue to the center, comb out and brush the ends, cut off a side and glue it onto the cap. Continue adding the yarn going all the way around and filling in the center to make a wig that can be styled and trimmed to make a disguise for 11. I traced the doll's body onto a piece of paper so I can design a pattern. These two are for the back. This one, when placed on the fold, is for the front, and we'll need these for the collar. Oh, and we might want a sleeve and a cuff. I place it on a light pink fabric, remembering to put the front on the fold, lightly trace around it, then cut them out. I cut most of the dress out in pink and made the collar white. Take the front and back of the dress, line them up at the shoulder, sew right across the top. I am doing a straight stitch with a 1/4 inch seam allowance. After attaching one side, sew on the other. Now I'm going to sew lines straight across the top. I want these lines to be loose, and I'm sewing them 1/4 inch apart. Make sure each one has a nice amount of thread left over on the sides, so you can go line by line, taking a thread and pulling to gather. After gathering all the lines, lay it with the good side facing up, place the sleeve with the good side facing down. I use pins to hold it in place, sew a loose line across the end of the sleeves, then pull to gather. Take the cuff, fold it in half, match up the raw edges with the end of the sleeve, sew a straight line across to make gathered sleeves. Take two cutouts for the collar, stack them good side to good side, sew a straight stitch around the curved edge, leaving the bottom open so it can be turned inside out. Repeat to make two. With the good side of the dress facing up, line the collar around the neck, sew a straight stitch across the top, then flip it over and sew a straight stitch across the top edge. Fold the collar over the top edge and iron it down. Take the back of the dress, fold it over and line it up at the sides, folding the sleeves over as well. Sew a line from the cuff to the bottom of the dress, try it on the doll, and make adjustments where needed. I'm going to sew some elastic around the waist just to pull it in a little tighter. Hem the bottom. I added a tight zigzag stitch on the edge, match up the sides at the bottom, sew a straight line an inch and a half up, flip it inside out, cut Velcro, sew it to the back so it can close. I like this Ken jacket, but it's the wrong color. So I take it apart at the seams, use it as a pattern on blue fabric, cut out each piece, use the collar of a blue t-shirt for the cuffs, bottom, and collar of the jacket, sew them together to make a dark blue jacket. Take one of Jenny's socks, turn it inside out, take the bottom hem of a white t-shirt, fold it in half so the good side is on the inside, place the sock at the fold, trace around it, sew on the line drawn, trim off the excess, turn it inside out, place it on the end of a brush, use fabric markers or paint to make stripes to make her a pair of socks. Give her a box of our printable waffles, then place her in our Stranger Things doll room to create a fun scene. I really like how we were able to use an articulated kid doll to create our custom 11, who has the option of wearing a wig when she needs a disguise. We can use our removable doll makeup technique to make it look like she's been using her powers. And since that is removable, we can clean her face whenever we like. My favorite part of this project is definitely the wig. And I am loving that serious expression. Thank you for joining us while we made our custom 11 from Stranger Things. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog.
And you're done.
Happy crafting! Little by little, piece by piece, I take back what's been stolen from me. Little by little, piece by piece, until I'm complete.
We want to give a shout out to Cheska the Great. What's up? All right, who is eating all of the waffles? Whoa, okay, never mind. Here, you can have them all. Piece by piece, I take back what's been stolen from me. Little by little, piece by piece, until I'm complete.